might seem like a pretty everyday thing, but in fact, really appreciating the laws governing motion took a lot of time and a lot of deep thought. You just think of something like a single rock or a single grain of sand. It really seems to be quite simple, but when you put a large collection of these particles together and let them start to interact, that all kinds of interesting behaviors can develop, and some of these are things that you would not anticipate at all. The basic forces involved in an avalanche are gravity acting to pull the material down the slope, and then friction, which is resisting that pull of gravity.
For a snow avalanche, we need snow. We need a slope, and we generally have a weak layer, often set between two stronger layers, and then we hit it with a trigger, the whole thing can take off.
What really happens in an avalanche is an impediment to escape. And that means you can see an avalanche on the tiniest scale, a little bit of powder heaped up, a little bit of sugar heaped up, but also a very large avalanche of the mountain size.
Avalanches are a lot more than just the common snow avalanches that people usually think of. Really, any kind of granular material can avalanche.
Granular material is a collection of any kind of materials, any kind of particles that are individually solid, but that together behave in ways that are sometimes liquid-like, sometimes solid-like. Essentially, everything that's part of our industrial society starts out or becomes granular material.
And if you think about it, everything that you eat